Sound design.
So how do we measure a speaker in a room with SATlive? We verified our audio analyzer setup. We measured a microphone cable. We measured an EQ. And now we're ready to measure a speaker in a room. But before we actually hit play, let's think about what to expect, what kind of assumptions we have here. So I think one of the best ways to do this is to have something we can compare it to already. And if you have the exact speaker measured somewhere else already, that's the best thing, right? And sometimes you can do that. So here's our speaker. We've got a JBL PRX615M. And sometimes you can look around, either from the manufacturer or just by Googling around, you can find an impulse response or someone else's measurement that then you can just import, and then you have something, a really close comparison, and that's great. And then you can say, oh, look, this is a speaker in a room from someone else. Let me see if my speaker in my room looks the same. A lot of times you can't do that. So what I do as a backup is I'll just import a Meyer sound speaker because I have, just from exporting from MapXT, I have all of the Meyer sound speakers as CSV files, as smart traces, and as impulse responses. What I did here then was I right-click on one of these quick traces. I click Import CSV Data. And then from here, I can load any of my Meyer sound traces. Now, this shouldn't be impulse response. It should be... frequency and phase response. I am happy to share all of these with you because someone else gave them to me. So I'll put a link below this video where you can download those. So what I did was I grabbed a UPQ because I feel like that's pretty close to what I have here, 15-inch driver on the low end. And then I just imported that. Now, when you first import this, the amplitude display is going to be way up too far for you to even see. So the first thing you need to do is just hit the center trace button here, and that'll bring that down an offset of about minus 109 decibels. Great, so now we have a speaker to look at. Now remember, this is a $10,000 speaker in an anechoic chamber that we're about to compare to a $500 speaker in my room at home with a bunch of reflections and stuff. But now we have something. And you'll notice that the phase trace did not import. I'm not exactly sure how to get that in there. So if you know how to do that, if you know how to take one of these CSV files or take one of these measurements originally from MapXT, get it into a quick trace in in SATlive, let me know, because I would love to know how to do that. But for now, all I have is the amplitude trace to go on. So at least I have a speaker here to look at. So I'm gonna take that away for a second. What else should we think about? Well, we probably wanna guess, what is our delay finder setting gonna be? Well, I know that it takes about a millisecond for the sound to go through the X32. So it takes about a millisecond for the sound to come out of my computer's audio interface through the console and get to the output. So that's 1 millisecond. And then how far away is my microphone here from the speaker? Well, if it's about 3 feet, that's about 3 milliseconds. So let's guess that my delay setting is going to be about 4 milliseconds. Why do I care? Well, if it's something really far off, like 40 or 50 milliseconds or negative 100 milliseconds, then I'll know that maybe something's wrong. So I want to have an idea of about what to expect in each of these settings. So I expect maybe some amplitude sort of like this, and I expect a delay of about 4 milliseconds. So let's go ahead and hit play on the measurement and see what we get. So this is a new installation of SATlive because I had to reinstall Windows through Parallels. So not all of my display settings are the way I like them here. So let's change a couple of things. I want to stop the generator on memory assignment so that when I hit Shift 2, to record that quick trace, it stops the generator so I don't have to listen to it. Secondly, I don't really like when the live trace fills to the center like that. So I want to go to my trace controls. Here we go, trace layout. Filter center amplitude. There we go. And now let's get rid of those anyway. Cool, so now I've got that UPQ, and here's my PRX that I just made. Okay, obviously not the same thing, but at least I know, okay, this is what a UPQ in an anechoic chamber looks like. Here's what my PRX in my room looks like right now. And wow, this is really hard to read. So what we can do is left click and then shift that phase around so it's just a little bit easier to. Okay, so it looks like the delay locator has locked onto this area up here, and then everything below that is arriving late. So a lot of wraparounds, but maybe that's normal for this kind of speaker. At this point, I just want to help you take the first steps with measuring a speaker in a room so that now you can start playing around with it. And you can start connecting what things look like in a room with what things look like on your graph, on your audio analyzer. So that this speaker in this room with this measurement microphone position looks like this. And then I move it around and I see what the changes are. And as I play with this and spend some time with it, I can start to maybe see some trends. Ah, when I change this, the high frequencies do this. And when I move the microphone down, then it's measuring more of the low frequency driver. And then you can start saying things about that. But this is just the first step. We're measuring a speaker in a room. So if you're not getting these kind of results, post a question below this video and I want to try and help you out. I want you to get to this step so that now we can move on to the next steps and talk about measuring other things, talk about why these things are happening. That's it. If I were to continue playing with this by myself, I would probably, move the microphone closer. I'd move it up and down. I'd aim the speaker at the wall, move the microphone way over there, and just keep saving traces and then look at how things are changing. Okay, so let me know if this is working for you and I'll see you in the next video.
Sound design.